Shivarnam. Atmajnana, manonasha, vasanakshaya, these three sadhanas that are required to accomplish Jivanmukti have got mutual cause and effect relationship. One without the other two cannot be accomplished. So we are seeing the connection in terms of cause and effect between tattvajnana and manonasha, how they are mutually related to each other as cause and effect. What is tattvajnana? Was described, and in the absence, without the tattvajnana, the chitta vritti cannot be eliminated, cannot be terminated. Manonasha is not possible. Now the other way, if chittopashama is referred here is manonasha. If manonasha is not there, tattvajnana cannot be accomplished. So that we will see now. Asaticha chittopashame.
Asati chittopashame. Drutti vidi kriyamanishu rupadishu. Meha nanasti kinchana. Iti shrutehe. यजमानः अधस्तरः इत्यादेः इव प्रत्यक्षविरोधसङ्ख्या ब्रह्मा द्वितीयम् इति एतादृशः तत्त्वनिश्चयः न उदीयात्
न व्यतिरेक इन् टर्म्स् आफ् इन् द एब्सेन्स् आफ् मनोनाश हौ द Tattva-jnana, Atma-jnana is not possible, is being shown. Asaticha chittopashame. Chittopashama is manonasha. When manonasha is not accomplished, when manonasha is not there, and we already seen what is manonasha. Nirodha of vrittis means antakarna vrittis, no more surface in the antakarna. Cessation of antakarna vritti. Otherwise what happens? Like a flame, continuous vrittis emerge from the antakarna. That is the nature of the antakarna. So when these vrittis are not stopped, vrittiha, ittopashame, vrittibhihi grihyamaneshu rupadishu satsu. Automated ing is there, satsu, add there. So then these are there. Antakkarna vrittis, do they come just like that? Or they correspond or relate to something or connected to something? Vishayas. They are connected to vishayas. And through the media of these vrittis, you cognize the vishayas. So therefore, see, when chittopashama is not there, manonasha is not there, vrittis are bound to be produced one after the other like a continuous flow, and thereby vrittibhi grihyamaneshu rupadishu satsu. Grihyamaneshu, which are being cognized by the vishaya. Rupadi means vishayas. Rupa, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha, these vishayas which are being cognized, perceived by the antakana vrittis. When these vishayas are being perceived through the antakkana vritti, then what happens? Statements of shrutis like this, neha nanasti kinchana. There is no nana. There is no namarupatmaka jagat. What is there? Advitiya brahma. This is what shruti says. And what is your experience? perception of plurality, pluralistic world. Contradiction or not? How are you going to cognize Advitiya Brahma? He says that word, this makes no sense. Na iha. Iha means in this, here in this jagat. Nana kinchana na asti. Not even a wee bit of any duality. Nana means duality. So not even a little trace of duality is there. What is there is only non-dual Brahma. Iti shrutehe. So such statements of the shruti, do you know how they will sound like? They will sound like this. Shrutehe. Yajamanaha prastaraha ityadehe iva pratyaksha virodha shankya. Prastaraha yajamanaha. This is the statement from the shruti. What is meant by prastara? Bunch of kusha grass. Prastara is bunch of kusha grass. Now what does this statement mean? Bunch of kusha grass is yajamana. You know who is yajamana? Who is yajamana? One who is performing the yajna-yaga. Huh? Who is he? Is the grass, kusha grass, or a man? Man. Can the kusha grass be the man? Is it not pratyaksha virodha? It is not opposed to, is it not opposed to the direct perception? So therefore, will you take, oh, Shruti has said, Shruti has said, bunch of grass is who? Yajamana. In the field where the kusha grass grows, so many yajamanas will be there. Is it so? No. So therefore, prastaraha yajamana ityadehi, like such statement. So what will be there? Pratyaksha virodha shankaya. Because of the shanka, the doubt, which is opposed to direct of perception, means this statement of Shruti contradicts with our direct perception. So therefore, if that is the case, how are you going with the direct perception of the nama rupa atmaka vishayas through the vantakkana vritti? How are you going to ascertain that Brahma is advitiya, non-dual? What does it mean? Non-dual means there is nothing other than Brahma. And glaringly you are perceiving the vishayas. It's not a contradiction. So therefore your ascertainment knowledge is not thorough. So therefore shankaya, because Brahma advitiyam iti etadrishaha tatva nishaya, tatva nishchaya. This tatva nishchaya, this knowledge of the final reality that a non-dual Brahma alone is there, na udiya, is not born, means it doesn't take place, cannot take place. All they have to accept that, like a bunch of grass is a yajamana, something must be there. See, in such case what happens, no, we have to, Shruti has got a method of ascertaining, no, not Shruti, Mimamsa. Mimamsa has got a method of ascertaining the meanings of such statements which contradict the perception. They are at best what are called as arthavada. Praise of something or censure of something is there to drive home some other point. So, therefore, you don't take it literally as such, it is so, but some other meaning is there, that is what you conclude. Like that, Brahma is advitiya, there is nothing other than Brahma, maybe such statement and not a statement of truth. So that is how you have to take it, and therefore tattva jnana cannot take place. So this way, tattva jnana and manonasha are interrelated. In the absence of one, the other cannot be accomplished. Next one is the mutual relationship of cause and effect between the vasanakshaya and tattva jnana. So with the vatireka mukha, in the absence of one of the these two, the other cannot be accomplished in between, in terms of, or in relation to vasanakshaya and tattva jnana.
Vasanakshaya tattva jnana yogo paraspara karanatvam yatirekam kena aha yavanna vasananasha nashava
tavat tattvagamakutaha
tavat tattvagamakutaha.
vasanakshaya tattvajnana yohu, of these two, vasanakshaya and tattvajnana, paraspara karanatvam, the status of being, the cause of the other, each of them being the cause of other. Aha, Vasishta has this told, how vyatireka mukhena, in the absence of one, the other cannot be accomplished. How he has said, yavar, so long as vasana nashahana, so long as the vasana nasha, exhaustion of vasana, destruction of vasana, that also you know how it is to be accomplished, by through the shubha vasana. So shubha vasana is such a way that these vasanas will not surface at all. They have no occasion to surface, being opposed, overpowered by the shubha vasana. So yavat vasana nashaha na, so long as this vasana nasha, vasanaksha is not accomplished, tavat, till then, tattvavagamaha, tattvasya, tattvagama, not tattvavagamaha, tattvagamaha. See, avagama is knowledge, agama is arrival, means utpatti. Here is agamaha, utpatti. Tattvasya agamaha means tattvasya utpatti. The birth of tattva stands for tattva jnana. The birth of tattva jnana. Kutaha, is it possible? Means it is not possible. It will be explained. Yavanna tattva samprapti. So long as tattva samprapti, tattva jnana is not gained, tavat vasanakshaya na. Till then, vasanakshaya cannot be accomplished. How is it so? Is being now explained further. Whether you have got tattva jnana or not, never mind. This much you know. What is that? Sadhana chatushtaya sampatti, at the risk of repetition, it comes into annoyance of you, is it? Always it irritates, the shama, dhamma, viveka, vairagya, all this, repeatedly it comes. That much at least you know or not. So that means Vedanta is very clear, unless the sadhana chatushtaya sampatti is there, atma jnana cannot be accomplished. This much you know. Now this person doesn't have vasanakshaya. When vasanakshaya is not there, krodha, kama, lobha, moha, mada, matsara are bound to surface, because already the cause is that in the antakarana. So now, when krodhadi are there, shamadama etc. are there, which are the part and parcel of sadhana chatushtaya sampatti, in the absence of sadhana chatushtaya sampatti, atma jnana, tattva jnana is not possible. That is what it says. Krodhadi vasanasu anashtasu. So long as still these vasanas of krodha, kama, etc., anashtasu, are not sublimated, so long as they are not destroyed, means so long as they are not sublimated, shamadi sadhana bhava, because of abhava, the absence of sadhanas, like shama, mastery over the mind, dhamma, mastery over the indriyas, viveka, vairagya, because of absence of these, till then, na tattva jnanam udeti. Tattva jnana cannot be accomplished. It is not born. The other way now. So long as tattva jnana is not there, vasana sublimation is not possible. Adnyate.
Adnyate cha adhitiya brahma tattve.
Brahmanapayat. Adnyate cha advitiya brahma tattve. When non-dual brahma tattva is not directly cognized, ajnati, not known, means directly cognized, then what happens? What is the nature of the jagat for this person? Satya or mithya? Satya. So long as they are satya, kama, krodha, etc. are bound to be there or not. That fellow did to me like this, I will see to it. Means he is my enemy. So therefore I have to settle account with him. Krodha is there. So all planning goes on. So like this. So adnyate cha advitiya brahma tatve krodhadi nimittasya satyatva brahmana payat satyatva brahmasya anapayat. Apaya is termination, destruction, removal. Anapaya means non-destruction, continuance. Because the brahma, that these are real. These, what are these? The causes that produce kama, krodha, lobha, moha, mada, matsara, ahankara, all these. So they are real, and therefore the cause being there, so they cannot be eliminated. And therefore what happens? The vasana, the very fact that kama, krodha, etc. are surfacing, it presumes the cause vasana is still intact there. Vasana na hi, na kshiyate, there other reading is na hiyate, is not destroyed, doesn't get terminated, it continues to be there. In this manner, the mutual relation of cause and effect between these three pairs of sadhanas, which are necessary for accomplishing Jivanmukti, were described from the standpoint of vyatireka, that is, in the absence of one, the other cannot be accomplished. Now, anvaya mukha, anvaya dvarena, by thus pointing out the presence of one, the other sadhana can be accomplished, so that in connection with all these three pairs of sadhanas is being now described. Tatha or yatha, tatha, okay, here in your book it is yatha, I think, it should be tatha. Tatha, so also, uktanam, trayanam, dvandvanam, among these three pairs, what are those? Manonasha, vasanakshaya, one, tatvajnana, manonasha, other, then vasanakshaya, tatvajnana, third. So, in these three pairs of sadhanas, of these three pairs of sadhanas, tatrayanam, dvandvanam, anyonya karanatvam, status of being mutual cause and mutually the cause of other, mutual cause and effect relationship, anvaya mukhe mukhena, so the means of connect presence of one, or through the means of connection or association, vayam udaharamaha, we are now going to describe, we are going to discuss. So the first is, here you take the caption, at least earlier, in the beginning that he had given the caption. Now he gives the caption at the concluding portion. So therefore here, now first is the what he takes for discussion is manonasha and vasanakshaya dvandva through anvaya mukha. Manasi nashte sati.
Manasi nashte sati.
Manasi nashte sati. When the mind is destroyed, you know, Satya Sai Baba generally produces diamonds. You know, when he gives diamonds, not diamond, die mind. It is die mind. Die manonasha. Die mind. So, manasi nashte sati. When mind is destroyed, you know now what is manonasha. Means no more vrittis are, that is, coming up. Then what happens? When vrittis are not there, can you cognize the external world? I hope you know how you perceive. How you perceive the world? Through the medium of viṣayākāra antakarana vritti. So a thought corresponding to the external object. When vrittis are not there, there is no cognition of the world. You can verify. When you are asleep, there are no viṣayākāra antakarana vritti. If anyone sleeps right now, can we right here itself can verify it. So no viṣayākāra antakarana vritti, therefore what? No cognition of the viṣaya. So that is what says, manasi naṣṭe sati saṁskārodbodhakasya bāhya nimittasya apratitav. How vasanas are generated? Because of the saṁskāras of the perceived things, is it not? So therefore now, viṣayavṛttis themselves are not, mind is naṣṭa, viṣayavṛttis are not there, there is no occasion for the production of vasanas. So therefore, say, manasi naṣṭe sati saṁsārodbodhakasya, means one who arouses or excites the saṁskāra. What are those? Bāhya nimittasya, the external causes which arouse, which excite the saṁskāra, the vāsanās, apratītau, being not cognized, being not perceived, vasanakshiyati. Vasanas get, that means terminated, they get annulled. When kshinayam cha vasanayam, when the vasanas are kshina, means they are no more there, they are nullified, hetva bhavena, because of absence of the cause, krodhadi vrityanudayat, krodha, kama, etc. vrittis cannot be born. As a result, what happens? Manaha nashyati. Because vrittis are not there, it is what? Accomplishment of manonasha. This way, tadidam tasmad, this is what? Idam manonasha vasanakshaya dvandvam. How? Anvaya mukhena. If one accomplished, other is certainly accomplished. So that way, in the presence of one, other is accomplished. Now the second path. What is it? Manonasha tattva jnana dvandva. With anvayam mukha. If manonasha is there, tattva jnana can be accomplished. If tattva jnana is there, manonasha can be accomplished. This is a vicious circle, you know, this is a vicious circle. If this is accomplished, that is the accomplished. If this is not accomplished, that is not the. Where to start now? You know that? It is somewhere you have to start, is it not? So that is how it is. Where can you start? Tasmad indriyanyadam. Start with the indriyas. By force, you will not be able to succeed totally, but whatever to the extent you succeed, you will be able to proceed further. So some beginning has to be made, and it has to be made at the level of indriyas. What does it mean? Dhamma. With the Dhamma, slowly arrive at Shama, mastery over the mind. To the extent you succeed in mastery over the indriyas, to that extent you will be able to control the mind. To the extent you are able to control the mind, to that extent you will be able to control the indriyas. Like that, but beginning, that's why Lord Krishna says, begin with the indriyas. So therefore, to begin with, don't sit in front of the idiot box any further. That is how practically I am suggesting. Don't sit in front of the idiot box hereafter. So that is, except Sant Tukaram. Except Sant Tukaram Satya Sai Baba. So that is. Actually, This can be a great means of education, but what is shown is trash. Can I say such a thing? No. Of course, it is used, but not totally as such, but it is abused more than the actual use. That is what is happening. Otherwise, see, what a great accomplishment. You see, you, somebody sitting somewhere can learn somewhere else, etc. But Vedanta will not work that way. You know why? That atmosphere will not be there. You are sitting in your living room with a cup of coffee in the hand and listening to the discourse and telephone calls and call bells and all this going on here and there. I don't know how it can be. See, that is how. Anyway. So now, this. The relation between manonasha and tattva jnana. Let us see now. Drishyate.
Nirindhanagnivat.
If manonasha is there, tattva jnana possible. If tattva jnana is there, manonasha is possible. So he says, you see now, those who had attended jnana swarupa vichara should come to help your help now. Those who have not attended, at least I have taken the same thing in atmabodha. Just last class I have taken how exactly atma jnana takes place. Generally, what is jnana? Forget Atma Jnana. Knowledge of any other thing. How do you get? What is meant by Jnana according to Vedanta? Chaitanya only. Not even Antakarana Vritti. But Antakarana Vritti is called as Jnana secondarily. Actually, now if Chaitanya itself is Jnana, we should have knowledge because all the time Chaitanya is there. No, not Chaitanya directly. I am talking of pratyaksha jnana, perceptual knowledge. It is the chidabhasa in the vishayakara antakkana vritti which gives the knowledge of the particular vishaya. Agreed? Same principle applies to atma jnana, brahma jnana. A person who has already got the sadhana chatushtya sampatti inquired into the mahavakyas like tattvam asi. In his case, what happens is a specific type of vritti, which is called as akhandakara vritti, atmakara vritti, brahmakara vritti, all are synonyms, takes place. What is the nature of this vritti? In vishayakara antakana vritti, the vritti thought is of the nature, the form of the vishaya in question. But atma, Savishaya or Nirvishaya, Sagunaha or Nirgunaha, Nirguna, Sakara or Nirakara, Nirakara. So therefore, that vritti also must be Nirakara, Nirvishaya. So that means, in the vritti, Akhandakara vritti, which corresponds to the Atma Sarupa, Brahma Sarupa, no vrittis corresponding to Vishayas are there. Manonasha or not. No other vrittis are not, that is what is manonasha. There what happens? Knowledge takes it. But only one difference. Nirindhanagnivat manaha nashat. So therefore,
already the Atma Jnana has taken place because through the means of this Atmaikya Abhimukha Vritti or Akhandakara Vritti. So therefore, so he says, that Vritti is no more useful, Anupayoga. Nirindhanagnivat Manaha Nashyati. The mind gets destroyed, manonasha takes place like Nirindhanagnivat, like the fire without the fuel. That last trace of Akhandakara Vritti also has gone. But one thing, this is theoretical. At practical level, for that Akhandakara Vritti to go, Nishtha is necessary, and therefore what is called Jnanabhyasa, repeated Akhandakara Vritti needs to be this thing, until that the Atma Sakshatkara, direct cognition of Atma Swarupa is so intense. Dragiva, just like that one can get the mind absorbed in the Swarupa, and that Akhandakara Vritti also is no more useful, it has become redundant. That is what Manonasha. So Manonasha, Manaha Nashyati Tadidam, this is what Manonasha Tattva Jnana Yoho Dvandvam. To Anvaya Mukha, Anvaya Dvarena, in the presence of one other gets accomplished, in that is in relation to Manonasha and Tattva Jnana. Then finally, how the Vasanakshaya and Tattva Jnana have got cause and effect relationship in terms of in the presence of one giving rise to the accomplishment of the other is being described now. Tattva Jnanasya.
Tattva Jnanasya. Prothani Vasanakshaya Hetutam. Vatikara Aha. Vibhau Bandhau Swadehecha.
Vibhau Bandhau Swadehecha.
Samai Atmyam Prapashyata.
Samai Atmyam Prapashyata.
Tattvajnanasya krodhadi vasana kshaya hetutam vartikakaraha ah vartikakara Sureshwaracharya in Naishkarmya Siddhi chapter 2 stanza 18 he has described the Tattva Jnana as the means of overpowering, annulling the Krodhadi Vasana. Means in the wake of Tattva Jnana, anger, greed, desire, etc., all these Vasanas get destroyed. This is what Sureshwaracharya has pointed out in the Naishkarmya Siddhi. Tattva Jnanasya Krodhadi Vasanakshaya Hetutam. Tattva Jnana having the status of being the cause of kshaya, the termination of vasanas, of krodha, anger, greed, desire, etc. Vartikakaraha aha. What he has said? Ripau bandhau svadehecha samaikatmyam prapashyataha vivekinaha. Vivekinaha, in the case of this jnani, here vivek is jnani, in the case of this jnani. Who is this jnani? Prapashyataha. Prapashyataha means anubhavataha. One who has got sakshatkara, one who has got the anubhav of what? Samaikatmyam. Samaikatmyam means nirvishesha aikatmyam. Means presence of one and the same Atma. Samaikatmyam means nirvishesha aikatmyam, means the presence of one and the same Atma. Where? Ripau, in the enemy. Bandhau, in the bandhu. Bandhu, bandhau, in the relatives. Swadehecha, in one's own body. The jnani who directly experiences one and the same Atma in all including enemy, relatives, one's own embodiment, he says, for such a person, kutaha kopaha, how come anger be there? Anger is always towards whom? Towards other. No, you say, no, I got angry with myself. Angry with myself means what? Either the body or the mind. Why did I do like that afterwards? So that means something else. So that is how it is. So, vivekinaha, kutaha, kopaha. So how can there be kopa? For which illustration is given? How is that? Svadehavayaveshu iva. In the svadeha avayaveshu, in the limbs of one's own body. While eating, your teeth bit the tongue. What? You take a hammer and then what did you do? And knock off the teeth, is it? Teeth bhi mera hai or tongue bhi mera hai. So you have that me as the entire embodiment. So therefore there is no such a thing at all. So swade, that is in the entire body, seeing only me alone, there is no, what is called, comparison between the, this, that avayavas as such, which is important. Anatomically they may say, but for a practical person, everything is important. Everything is important. So like five fingers. They have to work together. They can't boast, I am superior, etc. Like that only. So all have to work in unison. So svadeya avayasa iva. So therefore what happened now? Tattva jnana is a cause of vasana kshaya, other way. If krodhadi vasana kshaya rupa is there, tattva jnana takes place.
Krodhadi vasana kshaya rupa sya.
Krodhadi vasanakshaya rupasya samadhe. Shama is defined as krodhadi vasanakshaya rupa. You can equate it. Krodhadi vasanakshaya rupasya means samadhe. So when this show of vasanakshaya of anger, etc., that that means mastery over the mind is there. Shamadhi, etc. In the shamadama, etc. are there. So, jnana hetutvam, being the means, that means absence of krodha, etc. What does it mean? He has got shamadama, etc. Shamadama are known, very well known to be the means of gaining the tattva jnana. Jnana hetutvam prasiddha means it is well known in the shastra. Same thing, Vashishta also describes Vashishtopi.
Vashishtopi.
Jnanat shamadayaha gunaha. Jnanat. By Atma Jnana, what is happens? Shamadayaha gunaha. If jnana is there, shamadama, etc. are bound to be there or not? Yes. Because he has no fascination for vishayas, etc. So therefore they are bound to be there. Again, other way also. Tatha, so also. Shamadibhyaha jnata. Jnata means jnana. Through shamadama, etc., what happens? One is able to gain the jnana, jnata. So these two, dve, parasparam vivardhete. Parasparam, these two, what are those two? Shamadi, that is vasanakshaya, and tattva jnana, those parasparam mutually vivardhete, thrive. These two thrive mutually. If shamadama means vasanakshaya is there, tattva jnana is born. Tattva jnana is there, Shamadamadi, Vasanakshaya, these mutually try. How an illustration is given. Padma Sarasi Iva, like Iva, like Padma, lotus, and Sarasi, lake, like the lotus and the lake, they thrive mutually. You know what this illustration is? Where do you find the lotus is? In the lake. Now, without the lake, without the water, can the lotuses exist?
No.
Now in a lake which is full of lotuses, do you know what happens? The lotus leaves, have you seen? Lotus leaves are big. They spread. When they spread, they bring a covering on the surface of the lake. As a result, the sun, heat of the sun directly doesn't go to the water, and evaporation doesn't take to that extent. The water is cool and it doesn't get evaporated. Lake survives for a longer period. So which you see how it is. So the lotuses exist because of the lake, and lake continues to be because of the lotuses. This is how mutually, that means Padma Sarasi Iva. So by Shamadamadi, which means Krodhadi Vasanakshaya Tattvajnana, by Tattvajnana Shamadamadi, take it Tadidham. Tadidam. So this is what this pair of Vasanakshaya and Tattvajnana, as in the presence of one, the other one is accomplished, is described. That is what is called as Anvaya Mukha. So therefore, through the presence of one, the other is accomplished with respect to all the three pairs it was described. Now the next question comes. So with this discussion, what you have understood? To gain, accomplish Jivanmukti, Tattvajnana, Vasanakshaya, Manonasha, need to be practiced simultaneously, which was established by the Anvaya Mukha, Vyatireka Mukha, by pointing out how they are connected to each other, one being the cause of other. Now how to practice? How Tattvajnana can be gained? How Manonasha can be accomplished? How Vasanakshaya can be accomplished? That is there. Now, their sadhana comes. What is the sadhana for Tattvajnana? What is the sadhana for Manonasha? What is the sadhana for Vasanakshaya? Swami, this is a big course, this. Lamba chowda hai, bahut lamba chowda hai. It appears that way because you are analyzing it. You are analyzing it. So otherwise, not necessary. Sadhana chatushtya sampatti. Sadhana chatushtya sampatti is there, you will learn. No Jivanmukti. Tattvajnana will be there. Tattvajnana will be there. But further Jivanmukti, this is to take place. Nahi, theek hai. Nahi, to after Tattvajnana, you see, Jivanmukti attempt is after Tattvajnana. So, till Tattvajnana, you have to take the means of sadhana chatushtya sampatti, shravana manana, vididhyana. And suppose Tattvajnana take place, what other business you have got? What other preoccupation you have got? You know, only this has to be the only thing. Yes. Anyway, so now the question is, what are the means by which Tattvajnana, Manonasha, Vasanakshaya can be accomplished? Paurushena durataha, not paurushena, not durataha. The Sanskrit language is Paurusena Ruid Rasva Du Dirga Durata Raghavacha Tattva Jnana Dinam Trayana. Of this trio, what are those? Tattva Jnana, etc. What is that etc.? Adi Manonasha Vasanakshaya Trayana Sampadane for their accomplishment, to gain them sadhanam aha. This aha still pertains to anuruti, vasishta only, yoga vasishta. So aha, so the means to accomplish tattvajnana, manonasha and vasanakshaya are told by who? The vasishta in yoga vasishta. What is it? Raghava. So Raghava, Lord Rama, Raghava. Tasma, therefore, what is this therefore? Because tattvajnana, manonasha and vasanakshaya are interrelated as the one as the cause of the other. Not only that, what further? Because their simultaneous practice is indispensable. And because even if you take any one of them, even for a long period of time, that thing itself cannot be accomplished. All this has to consider. And that is, only the simultaneous practice of these three can confer Jivanmukti, and not individual practice of anyone, even if practiced for a long time. All this is there in the therefore. Tasmat, Raghava, Tasmat, Vivekina, by a Viveki, Viveki Purusha. So, Paurushena Yatnena. So, what is Viveka also will be described and will be commented upon. Paurushena Yatnena. By Paurusha Yatna. What is Paurusha Yatna? We can say by industrious effort. In fact, he is going to explain that. What exactly the Paurusha Yatna is going to explain. We can take for the time being as by industrious effort, with total enthusiasm, that I am going to accomplish, come whatsoever. So that is Paurushena Yatnena. What should be done? Bhogecham Duratah Tektva Ire Majama Aglaya. Bhogecham Duratah Tektva. Having abandoned the desire for sense enjoyment, what? Duratah, not alone, to come anywhere near. Do you know why? Even if little trace is there, that will ramify and then will swallow everything. So therefore, all this why Duratah also is going to be explained. He is going to explain every word. Duratah Tektva, what should be done? Etat Trayam Samashrayi. Etat Trayam Samashrayi. These three, what are those three? Tattvajnana, Manonasha, Vasanakshaya. Samashrayi should be resorted to, take shelter in these three. How? Durataha Bhogecham Tektva. So by giving, that means abandoning the desire for sense enjoyment by all means, not allowing it to come anywhere near, by industrious effort, one should take to the practice of these three. So what is that Paurushaha Yatnaha? He explains.
Paurushaha Yatnaha Kenapi Upayena Avashyam Sampadayishyami Iti Devam Vidaha Usaha Rupaha Nirmandaha Vivekaha Nama Vibhajya Nishchayaha.
What is Paurusha Yatna? What is Viveka? Describe. Paurushaha Yatna. This is what Paurusha Yatna. What is it? Kenapi Upayena. By any means whatsoever. No, in that English there no buy, beg, borrow, steal. Not in that is not here, but that spirit. Do whatever, buy, beg, borrow, steal. They say, Kenapi Upayena Avasham Sampadayishami. certainly I am going to accomplish. What? Jivanmukti. By come whatsoever, I am going to iti of this nature. Evam vidha utsaha rupaha nirbandha. Nirbandha means intentness, conviction. Nirbandha means intentness, conviction, firm resolve and acting in accordance. Not simply firm resolve. Otherwise, New Year resolve it will be. Firm resolve and acting in accordance with that. Intentness, conviction. What conviction? So, by any means whatsoever, I am going to accomplish with such evam vidha utsaharupaha. Utsaharupa means in the form of enthusiasm. Enthusiasm. Enthusiasm backed up by due efforts. Not just over-enthusiasm, with due effort. So that is what is called paurushaha yatnaha. So not mediocre, this thing. Dekhenge, abhi next year Mahabaleshwar camp mein dekhenge. Agar Mahabaleshwar nahi toh Lonavala hota hai ka dekhenge. Somebody also told Lonavala. So dekhenge, it's not that. So therefore, I will do that. Now what is that viveka? Vivekaha nama vibhajya nishchaya. A definition viveka. Vibhajya nishchaya. Vibhajya, having distinguished. Nishchaya, ascertainment. Ascertainment through thorough distinction or distinguishing. Or it can vibhajya, means having discriminated. Nishchaya, an ascertainment with due discrimination or ascertainment having distinguished properly. See, vibhajya means, literally means separation. Means breaking means separating, separating. Separating means what? You are ascertaining exactly what it is. So, vibhajya nishchaya. So, this is what is required. Now, let us see what are the means to accomplish each of these three. So, what are the means of tattva jnana, what are the means of manonasha, what are the means of vasana kshaya, one by one is being enumerated.
Tattva jnanasya sravanadikam sadhanam, manonashasya yogaha, vasana kshayasya pratikula vasana utpadanam iti.
Tattva-jnanasya sadhanam shravanadikam. The means of gaining atma-jnana, tattva-jnana is shravanadikam. What is shravanadikam? Shravana, manana, nididhyasana. That is that. Manonashasya sadhanam yogaha. Yoga here is ashtanga yoga. So ashtanga yoga is the means of destroying the mind. Vasanakshayasya sadhanam pratikula vasanotpadanam iti. The means of vasanakshaya is generate, produce, pratikula, opposing vasana. Opposing vasana. And opposing vasanas will be in what way? Malina vasana nobody wants. Therefore, shubha vasanas to counteract the malina vasanas iti. So therefore, this is what is taught. Therefore, yatnena. That yatna is this. Paurusha already explained, Viveka already explained, yatna. Yatna is this way. Shravana mandasana for tattva jnana, yoga for manonasha, pratikula vasanotpadanam for vasana. Then, why that durataha bhogecham tektva was to? What is that? So, like an outcast, no, not allowing to come anywhere near. Why it is said? That is being now explained.
Bhogechayaha svalpayaha kami abhyupagame abhisa krishna vartmeva bhuya eva vivartate iti nyayena ati prasangasya durvaratvat dur Mulakaha iti uktam.
Bhogechayaha. This bhogecha, desire for sense enjoyment, is such that even if you give a little allowance, it takes care of you. it totally controls you afterwards. Therefore it says, bhogechayaha svalpayaha abhyupagami. When allowed, accepted means when allowed. How much? Svalpayaha api bhogecha. Not much, yes, sir. The desire for little sense enjoyment, even if you allow it, you know what does it do? By this nyayena, by this rule, what is it? Havisha Krishna Vartma Iva Bhuyaha Eva Abhivartate. Krishna Vartma is fire. Fire is called Krishna Vartma. Do you know why? After burning, this fire leaves a black trail. So because black trail is left out after burning, Krishna Vartma. Krishna Vartman. Vartman means path. So black path means, that is what remains is charred thing only. So therefore, Krishna Vartma, Havisha, you know, Havish, in the Yajna Kunda, so fire is burning and you offer the Havish. Little, what happens? It grows. So Bhuyaha Eva Abhivardate. So again and again it grows. Iti nyayena, by this rule, what happens? Even if you allow a little desire for little, not little desire for little, desire for little enjoyment. So little desire, desire for little, that is svalpa bhoga, icha for alpa bhoga, little bhoga. Even if you allow, what happens, you know? Atiprasangasya durvaratva. Here atiprasanga is excessive attachment in this context. Excessive attachment is what? Durvara, unavoidable, impossible to ward off. So you have allowed only desire for little, not much bhoga, little. But what happens? The very nature of bhoga being what it is, so what happens? Say, ati prasangasya durvaratva. Further ramification, excessive attachment being unavoidable. Therefore, what is said? Durataha. Don't allow the icha for bhoga even to the least extent to come anywhere near. So this way, these three are the means to accomplish tattva-jnana, manonasha and vasanakshaya. What was told now? These three need to be practiced together for gaining jivanmukti. Fine. First, Vividisha Sannyasa was recommended for what? Gaining Tattva Jnana, for which Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana are the means. And what is the phala of Vividisha Sannyasa? Tattva Jnana. Once you get it, Tattva Jnana is over. Now you want Jivanmukti. Is it not that after that you take to practice of Manonasha and Vasanakshaya? You already got the Tattva Jnana. Why that simultaneous practice? All the three together, because already Tattva Jnana is over. So this is the doubt. So he poses this doubt, and then why do you say this way all together, etc. So the answer will be given to this.
Om Swasti Prajabhya Pradipalayantam
Amarena Adena Mahimahisha Soka Nidya Namasukyam Loka Samasta Sukhinam Bhavantu Kaya. Purnamidam 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 Purnamidam